Thank you.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Colin, so nice to see you. I think you look fantastic.
Thank you. You don't think I'm,
I don't see it.
I'm going for that Richard Burton 1966 look. Right after Beckett before Virginia Woolf.
I think that's when Burton was in his prime.
Oh,
excuse me, but that's his best stuff. Now, let me say, I understand you got a little treat for us tonight.
Oh,
in addition to some fine stand-up, you got a little something extra for
us. It's my my St. Patrick's Day poem that I wrote. It's from the POV, point of view, of a typical Long Island guy out there on the St. Patrick's Day parade. Okay?
All right.
Thank you, boys. It goes with a haircut, too. I know. We're short on time. I've lost my, and I don't want to become like this guy that comes on like some idiot with poems like, you know, Henry Gibson or something. This is
this is
serious poem work, you
this
know?
Is not going to become your shtick.
Oh,
this
thank
is your,
you. That's all I'm doing.
This is your serious poem about St. Patrick's
Day. Thank you so much. All right. I've lost my friends and seven teeth at this festival to St. Patrick, puked, outduked, and oft rebuked, this holy day's unholy hat trick. Can't find the train, it starts to rain. I'm in a world of trouble and a house of pain. Still, this tradition I keep alive. It's in my blood at 0.25.
Isn't that what St. Patrick's Day is really all about?
Yes.
Colin Quinn, thank you
very
much.
Thank you.